You may remember a few weeks ago I have been experimenting a little bit with ribbons and how to create them, and recently I've discovered a new, a better way, not a better way, different way of creating ribbons that I'd like to show you how to make them in Cold Simulation, and we're going to look at it together right now. I'm in my default Blender scene. I'm just going to delete everything. I'm going to press 7 to look at my viewport from the plan. I'm going to go Shift A to create a plane, S and X to scale it at the X axis quite a bit, and I'm going to get by depressing the tab into the edit mode, Control R and type number 100, so it's just going to give me 100 loop cuts, and I'm going to press again. You want to be in a vertex selection mode and you want to select these end vertices like that and get into the vertex group and create a group and assign these vertices to that group. You can kind of check by selecting and deselecting these vertices to make sure that they're selected. I can even name it like ends. And right now you want to get out of it, go into the physics tab, click on cloth and choose silk, and under shape you want to choose that vertex group that we have created previously. Right now, when you're going to go and press play, it's just going to behave like a silk which is hooked on the end. I'm going to increase the size of my animation to about 1000, and I got to do the same thing for the cache under my Cold Simulation. And on top of it, I'm going to get into the edit mode again, select the end over here, and go shift and no control H, create a hook. It's just going to create a little empty which is called a hook, and I'm going to even increase that hook quite a bit so I can see it a little better. And right now when you're going to play the animation and you're going to grab the hook, right, if you're going to try to move around, nothing's going to really happen because your modifiers are not in a right order. So you just want to switch, have the hook first and then Cold Simulation after. When you play the animation, grab the hook by the G, you can kind of swirl this thing, you can kind of move it around like this and kind of freeze the action by pressing the space bar on your timeline. On top of it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a subdivision modifier to smooth it a little bit more, and I'm going to shade it smooth, which is going to give me even more realistic results. And you can kind of, you know, create different effects with this ribbon like that. You can even add other objects, like for example whatever products you may have, and in a physics tab you can create a collision object and they're just going to interact. Try it and let me know what you think.